Hoi 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 and welcome back to Gear Outdoors. Today is 31st of Mars and the last day of my noodle challenge. I have been eating those noodles now, 123 of them. I have the last one, the very last one here, which I will be eating later tonight at 8 o'clock. And everything is just fine. Actually, to make a short recap and summary, the whole challenge was an experiment to see how far I would be able to stretch my food budget if I only eat cheap and bad food. Because bad food and cheap is usually something that goes hand in hand. I will by no means say that these instant noodles from Mama's is a bad thing, because they taste really good and they give me a very good feeling of fullness between the meals. I have never once during this 1 month period felt any hunger between the meals, and I have to say that is surprising. I noticed it very early in the process, and I have been very pleased with the fact that it has stayed consistent. No hunger feelings, so that's a great big thank you to Mama's and those instant noodles. And before we go on, I think it's time to do a little recap of the things that I have done to get those noodles, and maybe a few pictures of the process. So come along and we will have a little flashback. Hoi hoi, Gia from Gia Outdoors. Now this is a slightly different video. And traffic. I am here today at Havaristen, where I will see if I find the noodles I need for my extreme noodle challenge. I'm gonna go inside, see what I can find, and see what the price will be. So if you want to come along, check out the noodles, check out this shop, I'm going in. Join me. Sorry about the mouth guard, it's mandatory in the shop. I found noodles, they have this one, beef and chicken. So I calculated I need 125 of these to last me 1 month. So I'm gonna start picking them, or actually even better, see if I can find some employee here to pick up some boxes for me. It's easier. So let's see what we can find. Okay, so I found the storage area, and I'm gonna see if I can find somebody in there that can help me.
A few moments later. Thank you.
And welcome back! A little flashback there from when I was to get the noodles and a few pictures on the way. Now, back to the summary. The result from an economical aspect is that I have saved a lot of money compared to our regular food budget for a month. I would say that this month has been at least 5 times cheaper. And it should be said that it's not recommended to do this for a longer period. 1 month is good. I'm sure I could have done longer, but the point was to try 1 month to see the result, both economically and, second of all, what would be the effect on my body. And I have mentioned it earlier in my other weekly summaries that I don't feel any loss of energy. I don't have any headaches. I don't have any problems physically or psychologically by doing this challenge. And that is also a big surprise. I was prepared for being sick and tired of eating noodles after a short period, but I am not, still not fed up with this. And actually my sweet daughter asked me yesterday, I think it was, if there's anything I'm looking particularly forward to eating, if there's something that I'm urging to eat, and actually there's not. There's absolutely nothing I can think of that is ranked like top urge list. People have suggested, oh, you should have some big nice kebabs or pizza or whatever, but there's nothing that is special. What I do, on the other hand, feel is that when I tomorrow can eat normally again, I am not sure what I'm going to eat tomorrow either. It will be what it will be. I have also made that suggestions available for you guys and for my followers on Instagram and Facebook. I have asked you to send me suggestions, and some of you have. I have 12 suggestions so far, and I think that will be good, because the way that I'm planning to do it is to take one of those dices that I used to use while playing role-playing games. Like the old Advanced Dungeons and Dragons when I was younger. We used those different sided dices. And I have a 12-sided dice, so I will use that one for selecting the foods. But that will be tomorrow, and the food I will be eating on Easter Eve, because it will be an Easter feast. So a lot of you have given me suggestions on a starter, a main dish, and a dessert. So tomorrow I will use my 12-sided dice to see what I will have to be making. And that's it, I guess. I'm sure that some of you are curious as to how much did I lose in weight, because I have kept you up to date on the weight loss. And there is a tendency here. The beginning were the kilos, I lost them faster, and more of them, and then this gradually slowed down. But today, the last day, I weighed in this morning, and my total weight loss is 14.5 kilograms, and I'm very pleased with that. So now the challenge is, after this Easter feasting, to try to stay more focused on healthy foods. And that will be my goals for some time forward, period. So, enough said. I will not be releasing this video on Sunday because I am waiting and adding all that food selecting process tomorrow with the dice and everything, and also the food making process on Easter Eve on Saturday. So I will be releasing this video on Sunday, first day of Mars. First day of Easter. So I see you then. And for now, thank you for watching, and don't forget to hit the like button, and as well the subscribe button, and help sharing this video and this channel so it can grow together with me and you. Thank you very much, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye. Hello! This is the end. This is the end of everything regarding the noodle challenge and the Easter feast. Thank you so very much to everybody that has seen my videos, commented, asking questions, everything. Thank you very much. I am about ready to eat this dish now. I have here the starter and the main dish. You have already seen everything that is going on, how I made it and what it is, with those few tweaks that I have chosen to do to make it exciting. I have never made anything of this before, so I am excited to try it. It looks very good, I have to say. So thank you very much to both Kristin, who suggested the starter, and to Ellen, who suggested both the dinner and the dessert, which I will be eating later. It's still in the oven. It's about ready to come out now. So, with nothing further to do, I say thank you very much for having joined me on this journey. Thank you very much for having watched this video and the other ones. I hope you have time to hit the like button, and as well, while you're there, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification button. I hope to see you again in a new video. I will be going back to outdoors, hopefully soon, and spring is here, so good times. So for now, I say cheers, and see you soon.